let us start right with the outcome. But before I read the outcome, please forgive me, let's get a little bit of backstory. This was a small study, went over 14 days. Yet, it basically may result in you having more questions than answers. As, for example, what is the active ingredient in oolong tea which can yield you this particular result even while you sleep? So, let's read the excerpt, and then we'll get right into the public study, and then look at the abstract, or should say the full study itself, in a little bit. So let's proceed as follows. Beating the bulge with a nice cup of tea. Research led by the University of Tsukuba, please forgive me if I mispronounced that, if I did, please correct me, find that drinking 2 cups of oolong tea a day can stimulate fat breakdown while you sleep. To repeat, the study conducted utilized 2 cups of oolong tea per day. So those looking to achieve the similar outcome, 2 cups a day. And now to reiterate a little bit what we read in the first part. Publishing the results in a recent issue of the journal Nutrients, the researchers found that both oolong tea and pure caffeine increase fat breakdown by about 20% in healthy volunteers compared with the placebo, and that oolong tea continued to have an effect while participants were asleep. Interestingly, neither treatment caused an increase in energy expenditure. If I was to interject publisher bias and off my own hypothesis, maybe it can change your preference of fuels, for example, like from glucose to fat or proteins to fat, so to say. You get the picture, potentially. Indicating that volunteers developed a tolerance to the stimulatory effects of caffeine over the two-week study period as well. Reading through the study itself, it looked like the caffeine did have an effect at disrupting sleep patterns the first 1 to 4 days in the study, if I read that correctly. But to proceed as follows. Now, this is an interesting aspect, is what is the difference between green tea, black tea, and oolong tea? It's very subtle, both coming from the same plant. So, with that, let us proceed. While all tea comes from the same plant, Camellia sinensis, the degree of oxidation, a chemical reaction that turns tea leaves black, defines its specific type. For example, green tea is unoxidized and mild in flavor, while distinctive color black tea comes from the complete oxidation. Oolong tea, being only partially oxidized, lies somewhere in between and displays characteristics of both green and black tea. But while green tea is lauded for its health benefits, oolong tea remains more of an unknown, less of an unknown today, considering a potential outcome after 14 days of drinking oolong tea. I now want to go to the abstract. For those not familiar, I will have a link, what's called the DOI citation, which is a link to the full study, so you can validate what I am reading you here, and also too for the researchers out there, so you can look at the methodologies, so on and so forth. But the abstract here is important for the primary reason it gives you a better perspective of the composition of the oolong tea, as well as some other miscellaneous data, which is easy to look over. But the receipt as follows. During each 14-day session of the present study, 12 non-obese males consumed oolong tea, 100 milligrams of caffeine, 21.4 milligrams of gallic acid, 97 milligrams of catechins, and 125 milligrams of polymerized polyphenol. Caffeine at 100 milligrams, or placebo at breakfast and lunch. On day 14 of each session, 24-hour indirect calorimetry and polysomnographic sleep recordings were performed. Caffeine and oolong tea increased fat oxidation by, approximately 20%, without affecting energy expenditure over 24 hours. The decrease in the respiratory quotient by oolong tea, that's really something to take note of. And then many of you already know where I'm going with that, but I just want to stick with the study as it is printed. By oolong tea was greater than that by caffeine during sleep. The effect of oolong tea on fat oxidation was salient in the post-absorptive state. These findings suggest a role of unidentified ingredients in oolong tea to stimulate fat oxidation, and this effect is partially suppressed in a postprandial state. 2 weeks of caffeine or oolong tea ingestion increased fat oxidation without interfering with sleep. The effects of subacute ingestion of caffeine and oolong tea differed from the acute effects, which is particularly important consideration regarding habitual tea consumption, especially if drinking daily for its health benefits overall, even if the concern is not that of fat oxidation. Beautiful, beautiful. I would consider it a pilot study, which may leave you with more questions than answers. However, though, promising, promising outcome. A 20% increase in fat oxidation, you know, even while you're asleep, is pretty substantial. Now, keep in mind, the study only went 14 days. So in order to determine body mass, lean muscle mass, or basically weight loss overall through the consumption of oolong tea on a longer trial will have to be determined as follows. Again, all the information will be there for you. Gratitude, and also to an invitation for those that want to check out our data analytics, a reference to the COVID aspects of today, you know, looking at the our world and data, COVID tracking data, the CDC data, and so on and so forth, and to see any correlations or connections, or at least basically how the pandemic mitigation measures are actually panning out. You are more than welcome, and we'll be there usually Saturday night, Sunday morning. In any case, gratitude, thank you, and tell you quite honestly, even for myself, I'm highly interested in oolong tea now. Thank you for the enlightenment, reference to the researchers itself, to doing this research. Gratitude. Catch you all next time. Ralph signing off. Bye.